the mind design of doubting and fearing is to enable you to find the truth. Otherwise, you'll be misled by everybody. You have to discriminate and use the mind to discover something. And the best way to discover, as they say, the taste of the pudding lies in its eating. That means unless you eat the pudding, you really can't comment upon the taste. If somebody keeps on arguing about some taste and hasn't tasted it, it means nothing. You taste it, whether you can describe it or not, you come to judgment how good it is. Therefore, when you come across several spiritual masters, teachers, teaching various kinds of spiritual practices, and you are confused by just the multiplicity of these teachers, you wonder, what should we follow? What should we do? Employ your common sense. Employ your discrimination. You have doubts, surely. Do not dispel your doubts just because somebody says something. Keep your doubts on one side and get answers to them. Get clarification. Only when you satisfy your mind can you make real progress. Supposing you say, let me try it, but I have doubt about it, you'll never go anywhere. There was a man known to be a great expert in walking on water, a swami, a yogi, who had practiced some kind of a art by which he could do anti-gravity things and walk on water. And he used to walk on water every day in a very small, remote village. And everybody saw him walking. So an American doubter who said, nobody can walk on water. People just talk about it. I've never seen one. They said, go and see. So he went there, and he saw the man walking. He said, there must be some trick about it. There's something he's using in his shoes. There's something that holds him up. But I also want to try. He said, Swami, can I do this? He said, yes, you can do it too. Just do it without doubt. Say to yourself, I am certain I can walk on water. Without a doubt, you will walk with me tomorrow morning. So the man said, that's great. He's given a challenge to me. I'll walk with him on the water. And he got up next morning, and they went to the river. And the Swami said, come along, let's go. And he said, Swami, 1 minute. What if I don't succeed? Let me tie a rope around myself, and somebody will hold a rope. And if I sink, I'll be pulled out. Swami laughed. As they stepped in, the man went into the water. The Swami walked away, and the man pulled him out. If you want a rope to be attached around you, the doubt is already there. How can you walk on water? How can you do anything? When the doubts creep in, it prevents us from making any real success in meditation. That is why we have to satisfy our doubts. That is why many of the answers these perfect living masters are designed to dispel our doubts so that we are satisfied and doubts do not come in the way. And we are able to handle the doubts as they come and dismiss them because we know they're coming to disturb us. When we have that power, discrimination, judgment, to say this is a doubt coming to dispel, to distract me, I can put it aside, then you make progress. So I want to make these points because so many people get trapped in these things. They've been initiated for a long period and they make no progress, and then they don't know why. There's nobody giving them an explanation why they're not making progress. These are some of the answers to those questions, that these doubts will keep you in the way. Therefore, first remove your doubts. My own master, great master, Maharaj Baba Sawan Singh Ji, he would say that the people who are very intellectual, have many philosophies in their head, have read a lot, and have so many intellectual questions, take a long time to make any progress on the spiritual path, because they take a long time to understand how their doubts are coming, where the fear is coming from. It takes intellectual absorption for them. They intellectually absorb the teachings of a master before they can make spiritual progress. On the other hand, a simple guy, never read any books, comes from a village, he has nothing else except love in his heart, devotion in his heart, on the very first day, jumps up and has experiences of higher stages. It's not because his karma is better or something. It's just that the situation is different for intellectual, full of intellectual questions which must be answered before he can make progress. And the guy who has no questions, he has no questions. Therefore, he makes quick progress. But then, great master also added, the intellectual has one advantage over that other guy. And what's the advantage? Since he has gone through all the questioning, since he has gone through satisfying his mind, the mind after that does not disturb this mind, and he makes steady progress. The other guy can have a very quick experience. If something happens in his life, in his destiny, which he doesn't like, such as an accident, the death of a near person, of a child or somebody, any bad incident in his life, his faith shakes. So the faith of a person who is intellectual is built up later, after satisfying the mind, but stays longer. The faith of a person who has a quick experience of something and is not based upon any real study, any real satisfaction of the mind, but is based upon just the quick experience he had, when a bad experience happens, the faith gets shaken. So therefore, both have a little balance of experiences. One is delayed a little, but it's good. One comes quickly, but is still shaky till you have inner experiences. The ultimate answer is the proof of the pudding lies in the eating. That means the ultimate proof is you must go within yourself and verify what you have been told. If you do not verify yourself, your belief is blind. And the teachings of the great master do not allow any blind faith. They do not allow any blind belief. Do not believe just because somebody is saying something. Believe to the extent you are experiencing it. Improve your belief, add more to it as you experience more. But do not just be taken away by somebody's statements that they're making.